Hello everyone, in today's tutorial we are going to learn how to create a RESTful API using Node.js, Express and MongoDB. We'll be covering everything from setting up the server, connecting to MongoDB, creating the data models and defining API routes for CRUD operation. So let's get started. First of all, what we need to do is to ensure that we have Node.js installed on our system. If we don't have it, please go to the nodejs.org page and download the long-term support version for your operating system. When you just do that and everything will be installed, when you go through the whole installation, you can simply open the terminal, and by typing node.v, you will see that node is installed. In my case, it's like the long-term super version, so that 18.15.0. The next thing you will have to do, if you don't have, is to create an account on MongoDB. Website. So when you just create your website on MongoDB, you will have the screen like me right now. So if you don't have your account, please make your account, create it, pause, and if you finish, just go back to the watching and we'll create a database in MongoDB. Because it is very important to make it right now, because it will help us a lot later on. So when you just installed and everything will be okay, go to database and build a database. After you will see, choose the, for example, AWS and your region that's the nearest for me. Mine is Frankfurt, and use the free tier of the cluster. You can call it like RESTful API and just create. You will have to find out what are motorcycles or something like that. And right now you'll create your username and the password. So our username will be, for example, okay. And our password will be very simple. Choose, for example, auto-generate secure password for yourself. In my case, it will be like the simple password. I will just delete it after all, so don't worry, there will be no leaks. So after that, create user. And for that time being, it will be all. Why I would like you to have that as the first, because the creating database can take some time, and it will be very helpful and very needed in the next steps. So the next step will be to create a folder when we'll create our RESTful API. So when you are at the IDE, in my case is the Visual Studio Code, you should open your terminal. And after you open your terminal, you should be sure that you are inside your folder, and then run the following command. So npm init -y. We'll just wait a few seconds. Right now it's created and we are ready to go with the Node application, but we'll need to install a few dependencies for these projects: Express, Mongo, and some middleware packages. So to do that, we should run the following command. So npm install express mongoose, also cars and .env. And right now we'll wait. I will wait till it will be installed. It will take a few seconds. I will explain one by one when we'll create it. Okay, first of all, we just got every dependencies installed, and right now we will create .env file. Remember .env, that will be our secure file, that there will be, it will be handle our password and MongoDB link, so MongoDB URI. So we will call it mongo-uri equals, go back to our website, MongoDB website, and where you just got your database deployments, you can click connect. Connect in my case is like using VS Code, but you can do it without that VS Code, just copying that link that you just got over here, close it, go back to your .env, remember on the codes, paste it here, and when you just got your password, type your password, in my case it's like very simple one, and save it. And right now we will just leave the .env file like it is. The next step is to create index.js file. So it will be our main file. And the first we'll need to import some modules that we'll be using. So Express, that will create routes and our server right there. Mongoose. Mongoose is a library that will help us handle the MongoDB in very easy way. I will show you how, and that will be a very easy way. Const course. Course is cross origin, that if we would like to connect our application and go through, for example, front end application, I mean from React, will not get a course error. I hope that you will just go with that application later on, or maybe we will just go and build something more with that application. So we will require a course. Also we need .env to get into our .env file. So we will require .env file. Okay, and first of all we need to config .env because we would like to connect and get into that .env file. Then we'll just create our Express instance and our application. We will use our middleware. Middleware are a program that are in the middle when we just send a request and waiting for a response, for example, and in that case there are some middleware that the program does try to catch problems, handles everything that is related to that. So we'll just use course and also express.json. Okay, the next step we need to connect to Mongoose. So we'll just go to the process that env, that our file .env, and there we've got our Mongo URI. And then we need to make some setups for Mongoose. Your parser, like true, use unified topology. It will help us to don't get a error or some warnings in our terminal. So don't worry, you can just leave it without it, but it will help us a lot. And then we will make a DB as a Mongoose connection. But that's not all. We need to check error first if there is an error. Well, there shouldn't be, like that, like you see, that's the event name, so the event will be error. If the errors occur, you should console.log error connection, error connections, and the next one's open. When everything's okay, we should get the console.log, for example, connected. And right now we are connected to our MongoDB database. Okay, but that's the case only with connections to database. But to make something more, we need to dive deeper and go deeper with it. So first, we need to create some kind of route that we will just handle. So we'll need to request response, the express module, res.send, and we'll just send hello world, and it will be all to that case. The next thing, we'll just need port, and we can call it 3000. Of course, we can go to .env right there, make like port, call it 3000, go back over here and make a process.env.port or 3000. If it's assigned in our env file for that variable name, we'll handle with that. If not, we'll use 3000, and we'll use 3000 anyway. So we need to listen for our any changes. So port, and the next is console.log server. We need template string. Server is running on port. In our case, it will be port. And right now, our application should run. So node index.js, server is running, Mongo connection connected. Okay, so we need to make some kind of local host 3000. And as you can see, our server just show us what it should. So hello world. Okay, so the next thing, we need to define data models. Data models is like and schemas. This is how our Mongo collection would look like. Collection is like a data set where we just save and create our database queries. For example, if you are using, we're using SQL. So we'll create data models and schemas, as I said, and we will call it, for example, I don't know, but we'll just handle first of all to let our application go bigger, the models folder. And inside that models folder, we will create a file called task.js. It will handle our task data models and schema. And inside there, we'll just go to Mongoose, and we require Mongoose, and we'll create task schema. Briefly, task schema is like new Mongoose dot schema. Okay, and right there we'll need only two of them. Type is the type of the string in our case, the position that should have. If it is required, you can just also check. And I would like to have a true. Okay, and the next thing will be description of our task type string. And also we can go, we don't need required over here. And the next thing, we'll need to create a model from that schema. So Mongoose, I'll just go briefly through it, because what I would like to explain you why we are using it and how it will take more than one episode to do that. You should know the basics also of MongoDB. Just the basics. And that's the only thing that we are using over here. Okay, and we'll need to export that task. When we create our task schema, we can start creating our API routes for our CRUD operations. So first of all, to make everything clear, we'll create a new folder called routes. And inside that folder, we will also create task.js route. And right there, we will just handle some routes of getting the task, assigning a task. So everything that you just need for the CRUD operation. So create, read, update, delete. Okay, so we need also express, require express. The next thing we need to router. So express.router to handle our routes. And we'll just go to the task, our model. So we will just go briefly to models and task. Okay, we are happy to with our import, and we will just create the routes. First of all, we'll just get all tasks. So router.get, and with our main page, we'll async. So to be more precise, when you are using MongoDB and Mongoose, and you are trying to assign something or get from database, you have to use async await or and other options, for example, like fetch then as, or you can make it with promises, but is the easiest way to use async await to handle that requests. So we'll get request and response as always, and we'll try to handle if something goes wrong. Try const task equals await task.find, and that allows us to find the whole task that will be over there inside our task model. I will show you after we just finish, because right now it's hard to explain. The only way I can explain, when you just add 10 tasks going to that route, will send the JSON with the whole tasks that we that are available in our database. Okay, the next thing is cart error, and we'll raise the status. For example, this error, we will use 500, and JSON as a message, and error message. Okay. And for that, getting all of the tasks with from the database using Mongoose and using Express, that's all that we need. The next thing, we'll create a task. In that way, we don't get a route, we post to it. So router.post, and path will be the same, because we'll be using a postman later on. I'll explain you everything about postman also in that episode. And we'll just make request response and create some tasks. And new task is like we've got title, if I remember, title and description. Yeah, title, it will be request.body. The title and description, it will be request.body, the description. And that's the first case that we assign and starting to create our task in our database, in our MongoDB. And then we need to assign to our database. So try to handle any problems that will occur. const new, for example, task equals await task, so our variable, that's safe. And we'll just get back with the status, everything's okay, so with that task. If something will go wrong, we will just send like 400 and we'll assign JSON with message error message. Okay, and that's all that we need, and right now we created the task. Maybe we not created, but we create route for creating a task. The next thing, we'll just jump, we'll also get. Imagine we are having, for example, some tasks, and we would like to get to one of them. So, for example, you've got 10 tasks and you would like to see only fourth one. So how to do that? We need to get a specific task. For example, in our case, it will be by ID. And we'll just need router.get. And we'll assign ID as a params that we will just get through from our application. The next thing that we'll need is some kind of, we can use some kind of middleware or not. It will help us a lot if we will be using middlewares. If not, we can handle also that without any bigger problems. But also I can show you some kind of things that we can create and use the middlewares. So before that, we'll also create, for example, async function that will be like get task. We'll get a request, response, and next as a third argument. And we'll, for example, assign some task as an empty variable. The next step that we'll need to do is to get and try to get the parameters of that ID that we will just handle from there. And also we can, for example, get that task. It will help us later on when we just would like to update specific tasks or, for example, delete them. So it will be very helpful after all. So when we create that function and we create a variable with that task, we should try, for example, try. What should we try? We should try to assign something for the task, and we should try to get tasks. We call it task. Yeah. Task. Sorry. That find by ID, because we will be finding by the ID that will be served on the our inside our route. So to get there, we need to handle request that params that ID, and with that in mind, we'll handle our ID, whatever it will be, and using task as our model schema that we just as our model that we just served to our application, we'll be finding by ID. That's the function that we can use on our model and find out if there is any task. And we can check if task equals null, because there can be any tasks, and there can be, or then there cannot be any tasks. So we will return res.status 404, So we don't find anything. We cannot do anything for us. So that's not found. And we'll catch also when we just go try. Oh, for example, return rest.status 500 by JSON, and we'll also handle the error message over here. And of course, as you may realize, we still don't handle our task. So if everything will be okay, then our task will be fine. So that if will not happen, we can just make it as a response and assign it to it. And later on, the only thing is that we need to use next. So we will not finish over there, but go to our next route that will be handled. So right now, when we will be using get task, we will call our function that will handle and play as our middleware. So we will need only request and response, request and response. Okay. And rest.json, rest the task. And that's all. And right now we are only assigning to that rest.task and we are happy to go. The next thing that we just go. Okay, I will just call it creating middleware for our single for our ID args. Okay, so the next thing we'll need to we've got quote create read update. So we'll update the specific task. Update the specific by also ID. So router dot patch to update our app, and we'll use that ID. Also we'll use our middleware because we need to find if it's available or not, and we'll async function because we will be handling mongoose. Okay, something of everything's working correctly right now. And the request respond also. So if request.body.title, so we will get to the title. If there will be any changes of the title is not null, we will assign the title to request.body.title. So we are just getting back to our task that was fine. If it is fine, if not, there will be handled some kind of that's not found. If error will occur, we'll just get error message. And if everything will be okay, we've got our task. And right now we are inside our patch route. And first of all, what we'll do is check if our body, so what we send to the server, contains title. If not, we'll assign a new variable for that. And the next thing, request.body description, as I remember, yep, is not null. The same case. So task.description equals request.body.description. And right now we are handling if something was changed. If yes, then we'll assign a new values. So right now we only need to const update, so task will need to assign a new task, so to a variable, and make wait so our task will be saved. And after it will be saved, everything will go okay. We will return as JSON our updated task. Of course, we don't need to make that const assigning variable, but for our purposes to be 100% sure that everything's okay, we will just get back as a JSON response that everything is okay. Also catch, and right there we'll catch error and check if rest status 400, for example, and JSON, and also message error.message. And that's all. And right now we are also handling the updating of our task. The last letter, so D, delete, will be handled right now. So delete a task by ID. So router, not delete. That's the specific case where we can handle the delete operations. Then also we need the ID. So as patch and get the specific one needed it. That's why we use our middleware to not handle everything from the very beginning. That middleware handle that everything for us. And we need to make async request response, and also we will go through that. There is the removing our task from our MongoDB is very simple. We only need try and check await rest the task and remove. And right now we're ready to go. We've got everything okay, but we need to handle our response because we'll not that bad task delete it. You can also assign it and check which task. That's not the case right now. We only would like to have the message that everything's okay. If not, of course, 500.json and message, error message, message. Okay. And that's almost all. The last thing that we need to export it, our router, I mean that will handle our whole routes that we just got. And we now import our routes to our index.js file and mount them. So const our task router equals require, and we got the routes to our task. And inside of that, we'll be using our application, so our app.use tasks, Google tasks, and task router. Why we use task? Because we handle our main application over here, and I would like to stay everything correct. Okay, right now, if you are having the server connected like me, you can close it without any problems. And by node index.js, you can fire it again. Okay, and right now you should install your Postman. We'll be using Postman to check, perform the following operations. So get, that will just be able to get the operations, send the post, then delete, patch. So all the routes that we create, we can handle at the Postman. So that's the case that we'll just test our API. So I encourage you to install the Postman, it's free, and go to the Postman website, download. You don't have to create an account. And when you just download it, you can use without any signing in or creating the account. If you create and you will launch your Postman, you will have the screen like me, but you will have to go to the collections, and then you will have the case that you can add a new collection, and inside that collection we will handle our routes. So what we need to do inside our new collection, we'll add requests. And we'll only right now handle the post request that we'll need to do. So, as you remember, we are using HTTP slash slash localhost slash 3000 slash tasks. And with that, we can create. So we post. We check if our post, I will just show you, our post work as it should. So we go to the body. Inside that body, we go to the row. And inside that row, we choose JSON. And inside that, we are using curly braces. And right there, we need title, as I remember, yeah, title and description. Title, whatever. Description. Create an app. Okay, and we'll send it. And as you can see, the our collection to the database was sent and created. To check it, we can go to our MongoDB application, browse the collections, wait a few seconds, and in our tasks, as you can see, we've got our task with title whatever and create an app as a description. Okay, we don't want to have the task, so we'll delete it. You can just copy the ID with the without that object ID, only the number with that letters and so on, and we will just make not only get but only we'll just delete the response. So we'll paste our ID. We can copy it right there. And as you can see, we can create something like that. Will it work? You can say yes or no. I will just close the rest of them and we'll fire it up. And as you can see, where's the task that we move? It's not a function. So something go wrong and you know what we create, what we do. I mean, as a bad thing that we just don't get the ID and does not delete it. So if you don't see the error that will occur, that was my case. I forgot that the remove is not available right now with the newest Mongo that we just created, and we should just make delete that one. And we'll go back to our Postman, create, because I just deleted. I will get that ID. I'll show you that everything's work as it should. So wait a second. It will fire up the task. As you can see, with that B1 at the end, and we will delete it right now. As you can see, task deleted. We'll refresh it. Also wait a few seconds till it will be refreshed. And it's refreshed. And right now, the only thing that we need to, for example, check if it's the GET request with that ID that we just got, so localhost 3000 tasks and so on. And right now task is not found because we don't have any. When we create and go through with the task ID, as you can see, our whatever with description is created. And then next and the last thing that we need to check is our patch. So we just can copy it, our patch, and also right there we need our body, and inside that we'll, for example, check change our what we can change. We can change our title and to new title. Okay, and right now you can see that fires up and our collection is called. And when we just go to the gets Understand? The new title is set. And also when we just refresh our MongoDB website, everything should look okay with a new title. So that's all for that episode. I hope you like it. I hope that if you have any questions, you'll just leave the comments. And from my side, congratulations that you've built with me a RESTful API using Node.js, Express and MongoDB. You can right now, when you just got a course, you can use the API as a backend for various, for example, front-end application like React, Angular, or so on and so forth. If you would like to, we can connect that application with React and create some kind of basic UI for that. Further, for example, you can enhance that API to add features like user authentication, validation, error handling. So that will be all. So I hope you'll have a good day. Keep safe and leave a comment if you have any questions. See you at the next episode. Bye.